Hello everybody, this is Grandmaster Leonid Kritz for chesslectures.com. Today we are going to analyze Slav with a6. It is an opening from the point of view of black against d4 players. It is a very solid opening and we will look into the main line. And this is part one of the entire lecture, and the part two we will complete analyzing the main line. So the Slav starts with d4, d5, c4, c6, knight f3, knight f6, knight c3, and now instead of classical Slav with d takes on c4, black plays a6. His idea is obviously to take on c4 and to play b5 in the next move. White has multiple possibilities. He can play e3, he can play g3, he can take on d5, knight e5, bishop g5, all moves are possible. However, the main move, and the one which is not very pleasant for black, is move c5. The idea of this move is that white gains space on the queen side. Later on he wants to play b4, a4, b5. And at the same time, he already has the control over the square e5. He wants to develop his bishop to f4 to control the square even more and to suppress any counterplay from the point of view of black. In this pawn structure, black typically has two possibilities. He can try to play with e5 at some point after knight bd7 or after g6, bishop g7. Or he can try to play b6 and after b4, a5. We will see when black should play and how. In this position, black has two moves. He can play bishop f5 or knight bd7. The drawback of move knight bd7 is obvious. The bishop stays on c8. That's why the move we analyze is bishop f5. This is a more classical way of playing. White plays bishop f4, taking the control over the square e5. Knight bd7 now. And white has two moves. He can play h3 or he can play e3. In this part, we will analyze the move h3. And in the second part, we turn to analyzing what happens after e3. h3, obviously, the idea is to allow the white bishop from f4 to go to h2 in case black decides to play knight h5. As we will see later, after e3, knight h5 is the strongest move. Here, after h3, knight h5 doesn't make any sense. e6, standard development move. e3 now. The drawback of move h3 is that it takes time. Obviously, black is more comfortable in getting some counterplay. Now, after e3, there are three possibilities. Black can play knight e4, b6, or bishop e7. Originally, b6 was considered to be the stronger move. However, there is a development where white can get an advantage, namely after b4. Knight e4, and for a long time the main line was rook c1. After rook c1, black played bishop e7, bishop e2, black took on c5, b takes c5, black played queen a5, and after queen a4, black had a very strong move bishop d8, creating pressure on the entire position of white on c3. Later, if after the queen goes back to b3, black can play bishop f6 with idea knight d takes on c5, so black was alright. However, in recent games, white played intense move knight takes e4. Let's go back. In this position, instead of rook c1, white takes on e4, black takes with a bishop, and instead of allowing black to take on f3 and to push through e5, white can play knight d2, attacking the bishop e4. After the bishop goes back to g6, white can play bishop e2, bishop e7, short castle. And this position is slightly better for white, although obviously black doesn't have much of a problem. However, still he can improve his play. So b6 is a good alternative, but the main move in the 8th move, namely bishop e7, is still slightly better. Let's see what happens. e6, e3. Now we have looked at the 8th move b6. Black can also play knight e4 immediately. However, white has a very strong answer, namely bishop d3. Black takes on c3, b takes c3, bishop takes d3, queen takes d3. It seems like the problems of black are all in the past, because he managed to exchange this white squared bishop, which is usually a problem of black in this kind of position. However, there is another problem now, namely that the square b8 is controlled by the bishop f4. So that whenever the b file gets opened, and black has to play b6, otherwise white will play rook b1, short castle, rook b3, rook fb1, and exercise terrible pressure against b7 pawn. So black has to play b6. After this, white will gain the control over the b file, because black cannot put his rook on b8. So c takes b6, knight takes b6, with the idea to play bishop d6 and to exchange this strong bishop f4. However, after rook b1, black cannot play bishop d6 anymore, because knight on b6 is hanging. And after knight c4, white has a very strong move, knight e5. Black has to take, and bishop takes e5. So again, bishop d6 doesn't work, because the pawn on g7 is hanging. Just to mention, white takes on g7, rook g8, and white can take on h7, actually winning the game. So bishop d6 doesn't work. And f6 leads to a small weakness of the position, and in addition, if black plays later on bishop d6, white will take and play rook b7. A small advantage again. So that means that 8 knight e4 doesn't work so well. Finally, in this position, the main move is bishop e7. One of the main ideas of black is to play queen c8, bishop d8, bishop c7, exchange black squared bishops and f5. If this works, great, black has no problems. Bishop d3 is the best move for white. As I said, after bishop e2, for example, short castle, queen c8. White can try to play b4. Black has two possibilities. He can play knight e4, but he can also play bishop d8. After a4, he plays bishop c7, forcing white to take, queen takes c7, and the position is absolutely equal. In case white decides immediately, black simply can take and play b6, exchanging all the pawns on the queen side. There is no way white could keep the pressure, so the position is equal. If white doesn't play b5 on the other side, then the next move of black is going to be e5. Let's assume that white played rook e1, black plays e5, and gets a very good counterplay in the center. He wants to play rook fe8, take on d4. After all, even if white can push b5, still the position will be equal. That's why in the ninth move, the best plan for white is to exchange the white squared bishops. Here we are, instead of bishop e2, bishop d3. White wants to exchange the white squared bishops, play b4, a4, rook b1. Very important that he can take the control over the square b1. Black takes on d3, queen takes d3, and without losing time, black immediately plays queen c8. He wants to push e5 through as soon as possible. An alternative plan in this position is b6. Let's see what happens then. White plays b4, a5. It looks like black is even winning, yeah, because white cannot play a3, and if black takes on b6, white takes on b4. I'm sorry, if white takes on b6, black takes on b4 and wins the pawn. However, things are much more trickier here. White has a very typical reaction for this position, namely b5. You need to know this move. Whenever you play b6 and a5, white always can play b5 as long as the knight stays on d7. After b5, black has to play queen c8. He cannot take on b5 because of c6. After knight b8, c7, white is winning. He can also not take on c5 because of b takes c6. And again, c7 is a very dangerous threat. So, queen c8. B takes c6. Queen takes c6. Knight b5 with idea knight c7 to win the exchange. Short castle. Bishop d6. Bishop takes d6. C takes d6. Knight e8. Knight e5, knight takes e5, and this position is strategically won for white because pawn d6 is so strong and knight on e8 is very bad. So this is a typical example when black should not try to play b6. It doesn't work in this position, so be careful. b6 seems to be good sometimes, but very often it is not. Let's go back. Move number 10, queen d3, instead of b6, as I said, queen c8 is the strongest move. The idea is bishop d8, bishop c7, exchange the black square bishops, put the queen on c7 and play e5. Short castle, bishop d8. Actually, since black will have to play short castle anyway, it makes even more sense to castle short first and to play bishop d8 in the next move. It doesn't actually matter because whatever happens, the next moves are bishop d8, bishop c7 and short castle. Black cannot afford to play with the king in the center. So short castle, b4, bishop d8, a4 is the main move. Bishop d6 is an alternative. Black plays rook e8. The idea is the same, bishop c7. Knight e5. Bishop c7. Bishop takes c7, queen takes c7, f4. This doesn't seem very pleasant for black because he has no counterplay for the moment. However, in this position he already can play b6. b6. White has three moves. He can play rook ab1. He can play rook ac1 or he can take on b6. Let's look at all of them. I'm sorry, so here we are, b6. Rook ab1. Black takes on e5 suddenly. Just to mention again, a5 in this position doesn't work. White can take on b6. Knight takes b6 and b5. Pawn on c6 is hanging. If black takes on b5, white takes with the knight and he has a very strong initiative. All his pieces are very active and the knight on b6 might be hanging at some point. So black is forced to play c5. Then white takes on c5, queen takes c5, and rook f goes to c1. Black can play rook ec8, white plays knight c6. As you can see, white's position is superior. He has very strong initiative. The queen on c5 is not good. The knight on f6 doesn't do much yet. The knight on b6 is not strong too. If, for example, in this position black plays knight c4, the move which appears logical, white plays knight a4, queen f8, rook takes c4, d takes c4, queen takes c4, is a very big advantage because he wants to play knight b6 or b6 and b7. Black cannot do much against him. So a5 doesn't work in this position. That's why black has to take on e5 in move number 17. So instead of a5, knight takes e5, f takes e5, knight d7, e4, and black plays a5 now, because after b5 he can take on c5. E takes d5, e takes d5, c takes b6, queen takes b6, b5, and black can take on e5. B takes c6, and queen goes to a7. And in the next move, black will take the pawn on c6. Black position is even better here. So this shows that rook ab1 doesn't bring white any advantage. Let's go back and see what else he can play. Instead of rook ab1, another move is rook ac1. His idea to take on b6 and to attack the pawn c6. Here there are two moves black can play. He can do either b takes c5 or he can also play a5. Let's see what happens after a5. b5, b takes c5, knight takes c6, black plays c4. Queen c8, knight b8. Strong move to exchange this strong knight on c6. Knight takes b8. Rook a takes b8, a4, and knight d7, with the idea to put the knight on b6 and possibly even to play f5, closing the center, and this position is equal. Black is not worse. His pawn on c4 is a guarantee that he will be fine in any endgame. This is one possible way of playing against rook ac1, another one is to take on c5. After rook ac1, b takes c5. This looks more obvious because the b file is not under white control. The rook on c1, the only idea of the rook on c1 was to attack the pawn c6. Now after b takes c5, this idea will never work. B takes c5, rook e goes to b8. It is obvious why, because the pawn a6 is hanging. Rook b1 and queen c8. By the way, this is also another standard move. The queen on c8 stands very good because it defends both pawns a6 and c6. And in the near future, black wants to take on b1, play rook b8. If white takes on b8, black will take with knight. It doesn't matter that the knight goes back. It looks passive, but white has no threat. And in the next move, the knight will simply come back to d7, exchange on e5, and black will experience no problems. Finally, let's see what happens if in 17th move, white simply takes on b6. C takes b6. Queen takes b6, attacking pawn on b4. Rook ab1, knight takes e5, f takes e5, and knight goes to d7. And again, this position is equal. If white plays knight a4, black can simply play queen b5, exchanging the queens. In future, black has two ideas. He can try to play a5, However, he must take into account that white can play b5. Black can also play f6, which looks more reasonable. f6, and after white takes on f6 with the pawn, play knight takes f6 and try to play with e5. So this position is equal. Black has a good counterplay in any case. Finally, let's see what happens in the main line. This was 13th move, bishop d6. If instead of bishop d6, white continues with his original plan and plays a4. Here we are, so we just looked at the bishop d6 variation. Now we finish analyzing the main line of this part, namely a4. Of course, black plays bishop c7. Very interesting, white plays b5 immediately. If he takes on c7, queen takes c7, b5. Instead of b5, rook fc1 is an alternative, but then simply e5, knight d2, e4, queen e2, knight goes to e8, b5 and f5. And we can see that black has very strong counterplay on the king side. Next, he wants to play f4. If white plays g3, black plays knight e f6 and then g5 and f4. Knight goes to f6 to prevent that white can play queen h5. Time in is if black plays g5 immediately, probably queen h5 is not very nice. Although even here black can play knight, I'm sorry, queen d8 with idea knight g7. But it's easier to play knight ef6 and then g5 f4 is a very strong initiative. Usually white shouldn't allow black to come to e5 and e4 and f5 because that's too dangerous. So rook fc1 is too slow. b5 is the main move. a takes b5, and black plays b6. We saw this kind of position already. White takes on c6, queen takes on c6. In the next move, black wants to take on c5, so white is forced to take on b6, and after knight b6 we have absolute equality. This position is simply draw. That's why white wants black to take on f4, and white himself doesn't take on c7 in move number 14. Here we are, white plays b5. The drawback of this move is obvious, that the pawn structure gets distracted. Bishop takes f4, e takes f4, a takes b5, a takes b5. Now queen c7, strong move. We can see that the pawn f4 is hanging. And after g3, black can play b6, equalizing again. So nothing greatly has changed here. The same position, the same exchange, just that the pawn structure of white is slightly worse. However, black will never be able to play e5. But this position is very much like the one we have already seen. So this is the way black should play against the idea h3. He should put the queen on c8. And the plan you should know is bishop e7, bishop d8, bishop c7, exchanging the black squared bishops, castling short, playing rook e8, or simply pushing e5. And whenever there is a possibility, if white already played b5, you can take once and play b6. This is the second idea to know. I hope you enjoyed this part of Slav, and I thank you for your attention. I will see you in the next lecture. This is Leonid Kritz for chesslecture.com, signing out.